writer. You are doing a very good job. But anybody, if you cannot keep sensitive matters to yourself, then you should not have any business being around IPOB or ESN. None whatsoever. I'm saying it out in the open so that the whole world can hear what I'm saying. If you know you are not disciplined enough to do this very job, then please, I beg of you, do not go near our men. Do not go near our camp. Even if you run out of bullets, even if you run out of ordnance, you run out of what to fight with, you don't go about doing a video and announcing it. And anybody from today, if we find you in the diaspora aiding or abetting any sector, any group on the ground back home, you will also be in trouble. Because only one source of fundraising is allowed. We are under one command, not multiple commands, only one. If you want to help ESN, contact our sister. Contact the people that will release their telephone numbers. Not every idiot coming out to fundraise for us. We don't want you to. We didn't get to where we are today by fundraising like people who have no direction or sense of purpose. We are IPOB, we do things differently. We must learn as the Ekumeku taught us. It was Ekumeku that fought the British. Ekumeku, mostly in Ahaba. Today they call it Asaba. Some of the idiots that say, oh, well, we are Nyama Ibo, all those fools. Ekumeku was formed by people from Arojugu, seven sons from Arojugu, from Izuagu, mostly. Then went to Anioma. When Arojugu fell to go and fight the British. Do you understand that very clearly? Ekumeku was so secretive that the British became frightened. That is the essence and purpose of ESN. We must go back to it. Secrecy is key. Mind that careless talk cost a lot of lives. You must understand this very, very clearly. You must understand this very, very clearly. They are saying that Nigeria cannot have peace because those who occupy the upper echelons of power in the zoo in terms of the military are Fulani Janjaweed. Everybody is Fulani Janjaweed. Don't take it from me. A former military administrator of Ogun State is this Navy Commander Kayode Olofimoyin has berated the Fulani government in Aso Rock for filling every position of importance in Nigeria is manned by a Fulani person. Do you know the funniest thing is that they don't even obey the law? These are the same people that tell about law. Remember under Jonathan, the national character, obey all of a sudden, under their watch, under Fulani control of Nigeria, there is no more federal character. Everything is Fulani. Everything is Fulani. Now, this former governor of Ogun State is a Navy commander, Kayode Olofimoyin, is now saying that you cannot fill every position in Nigeria with your clansmen. They are doing it because Buhari is not alive. The real Buhari is dead. Everybody knows that. Only if you choose not to acknowledge this very obvious fact, because it's coming from IPOB and Nandekanu, you may not agree. That's entirely up to you. That is why Garoba Sheikh with Miyeti Yala, the Sultan of Sokoto, and of course their British advisors, they are the ones who are running the zoo. As I said to you before, what is happening in Nigeria today is as a consequence of those of you who were not brave enough to rise up to say that enough is enough. Nigeria is killing people by virtue of its existence. A Fulani terrorist cannot come all the way from Senegambia, come from Mali, come from Niger, and come to Southern Kaduna to kill you, or come to Opa to occupy your land illegally, or take over the, in fact, Delta State is gone. Is it that Delta they're telling you, you're not Igbo, you are Nioma, they have taken it over. All these people taking over your land are doing so because you are part of one Nigeria. You need to get this thing right into your skull. Some of you need to be able to reason very, very clearly and very well. The reason why they are coming in is because it's only Fulani, their own people, that occupy every, virtually every position of authority within the security architecture of the damnable Zoological Republic. They are allowing, look at Bauchi governor, the type of garbage coming from his mouth. Compare his activities with that of Hope Uzodinma that is killing his own people. This man is in Bauchi. He is not content, you know, with Fulani in Nigeria, lording it over everybody else. He even wants to go to Mali to bring more Fulani. He wants to go to Senegal to bring more Fulani. He wants to go to Niger Republic to bring more Fulani. He wants to go to Burkina Faso to bring more Fulani. He wants the Fulani in Ghana, northern Ghana, to come to him. He wants the Fulani in Benin Republic to come to him. He wants the Fulani in Cameroon to come to Nigeria. He wants the Fulani in Chad to come to Nigeria. But to somebody who is a governor, a so-called governor, in our land, in Igbo land for that matter, is busy killing his own people. I have never seen a thing like this before in my life. That is to tell you how demonic these people are. The same Fulani governor of Bauchi State. The ones telling you that you must have settlement, they are Fulani settlement in every part of the country, and the government must give them money. Why are they saying it? Because they are in the army. And under Buratai, they were giving guns for free to Fulani militia. Under the watch of El Rufai, the midget of Kaduna State, they were giving guns for free to their fellow Fulani bandits from across West Africa. Very clear. El Rufai went abroad to go and pay them by his own admission. He's a governor. He went outside Nigeria to pay people, to pay Fulani people. But inside Imo State, I didn't say outside Imo State, inside Imo State, I didn't say outside Biafra land, I didn't say outside Igbo territory. No, inside Imo State, the person you call your governor is killing you and is very proud and very happy about it. Now, do you understand why? The same way with Nigeria, the more these people continue to exist, the more we are going to die. You saw this, some of these governors we have. The more they are alive, the more Fulani will take us over. I'm telling you the truth. You see some of this, your Igwe, some of this, your PG, President General, some of this, your Eze, His Royal Majesty, His Royal Highness, some of these criminals with traditional titles. If you suffer them to live, believe you me, if you allow them to continue to live, we are all going to die. And the Fulani will take our land. You know, this is something I've been preaching to those of them in America, here where I am, for very many years, and they don't want to understand. You are doing, you know what is Kulanut, our tradition and all the rest of it. The children you gave birth to in America will not know. Their children will not know. Your families will shut down. They will shut down in the villages. Fulani will take them over. And then, of course, some of you have no shame. You have no regard for your culture nor your name. You have no, should I say, sense of responsibility towards your way of life and your traditions. The Jews survived for 2,000 years before coming back in 1948 to reestablish the state of Israel. But I can assure all of you that by the time the Fulanis take over our land, forever and ever and ever and ever, you have no homes to go to. That I can assure you very clearly and unambiguously. You have no homes to go to. Some of you in America are talking about Nigeria. You have no homes to go to. That is for your information. But at the very least, our Yoruba brothers and sisters can now understand what we have been saying from day one. I told you, I warned you in 2014, they will occupy every position of authority. And then the process of enslavement will begin. They are not going to enslave you by themselves. They will use people inside you to enslave you. They are using Tinubu in the West to enslave Yoruba people, but they don't know it. They are taking his presidency. They are using Tinubu to enslave Yoruba people. They want to use Hope Uzodinma, David Umahi, and the Wike to enslave Biafrans. That's what they want to do. Have you asked the governor of Delta State, if I recall, what he's going through? Have you seen how Fulani have just virtually taken over the whole of Delta State? Do you know Sapele is gone? Go to Sapele today. We got the report today. They are calling ESN. Please come to Sapele. ESN, come. Do you know Sapele is gone? Go to Delta State and see what is going on. Because you people do not reason very well. You, because you are black people, you don't. I tell you to your faces. You know, when this show you black people, you don't reason very well. When somebody is telling you that your brother is no longer your brother, it's because they have an ulterior motive. The reason why they tell you, oh, Delta is not Biafra. Oh, Edo is not Biafra. Oh, Cross River is not, is to make it impossible for all of you to get together to resist them. But all of them, they are one, including Benue State that doesn't belong to the corner. I want you, I don't know if I'm making any sense at all. Now listen to me, please, very carefully. I will try to explain what I mean very slowly. All these people saying, like weak, I'm Ipere, I'm not Igbo. I'm Iwuru, I'm not Igbo. I'm Ijo, I'm not Biafra. Those people do not know that in their ignorance, in their stupidity, they are helping the conquest of our land by the Fulani. How are they helping? Because the Fulani knows that a jaw on their own cannot defend themselves against them. Why am I saying this? When Fulani comes after you, Fulani comes in the name of the North. They never come alone as Fulani. Never. Because they do not have a defined territory. Fulani does not have a defined territory they can call their own. Only maybe Sokoto, which they even took from the Hausa people. Understand this very clearly. When Fulani comes, Fulani, they are very clever. Of course, Britain, United Kingdom is advising them. So they first of all manipulate the media. They use the media to manipulate all of you. They keep twisting your mind. They keep you until they get you. Once you fall for their trick, they now hit you. Do you know that before Britain left the zoo called Nigeria that they created in 1960, they created, I've said this before, the Willing Commission. Willing is a white man. Do you know why Britain brought them in? Britain brought them in to divide Biafra by telling Efik, the same Britain that I read in their own history book, the same Britain that told me that Ibibio and Igbo are one people, the same Britain, no? The same Britain that came to Hope, the established Hope Water Institute in Calabar, the same Britain that came and established the presbytery of Biafra. Before they even created Nigeria, they had the presbytery of Biafra in Calabar. So to them, Calabar was Biafra, even before Nigeria was formed. I want you to pay very close attention, please, because our people are so daft, they don't listen very well. The reason why Britain created the Willings Commission before they left in 1960, they were telling the so-called minorities, oh, you're from Igbo, we dominate you. Oh, we are concerned about you. Nobody knew that the concern of the United Kingdom was the oil and gas in our land, because they knew that if the Igbo people, the Efik, the Ijo gets together, they cannot take our oil and gas. Remember? I want you to reason very carefully. They know that if we are together as one people, they cannot take our oil and gas. So what did they do? They said, Ogoni, you're different. Don't enjoy, you're different. Even Ogoni, you are different from Eleme. Eleme, oh, don't worry, you're different from Obi Igbo. All of these people, you are all different. You are not one people. The reason why they're doing it is not because they are saving you from somebody who will dominate you. No, 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 no. They are doing it because the more you are divided, you create the opening for them to sink their pipe into your oil and gas and take it. And they succeeded. That is the reason why they created states. They did not create the states to unite you or to give you resources so you can have your own governor. No, 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 no. They created the state in order to divide you. So when something happens, instead of the whole of Yoruba to come together and say, no, no, do it by state. He's helping in Ogun State. I'm from Oyo. Well, I'm from Osun. But when they come after you, you never hear them saying Sokoto or Kanu or Katsina. They said enough. That tells you, that is to remind you once again that the more you keep dividing yourselves, the more you keep falling. How was it possible for them to plant somebody that did not win any election? Opposed Onyema never won. How was it possible for them to plant somebody who never from number four to number one? Because for 50 years, they carefully divided Igbo land. Very carefully and methodically. Very carefully and methodically. That is why even these governors, they could not raise their own. Now, you know the reason why they couldn't possibly raise their own security network by region. Yoruba did theirs by region. Mietiana did their own by region. But in the East, there was nothing. Why? Because if you don't have any certified security network like the ESN, they can keep expanding their settlements. They'll keep taking your lives over. I warned all of you before we have caused them we have preempted them by them coming to Olo before the time they planned to invade Olo. They want to take over Yoruba land with terrorists, Fulani headsmen, and then hit the East with their army because they don't want to spread the army very thin. If Yoruba starts an uprising today, which I don't know if they're capable of doing, but I'm praying they can, if they start an uprising today in the West, there is uprising in Middle Belt, uprising in the East. The army of the zoo cannot cope because in that very army, you don't have any other tribe, so to speak, only Fulani and those they brought in from the Sahel. Their army will be stretched so thinly. So what they have done is, in order to quell any restiveness in the West, they use terrorists under the command of Mietiala. Mietiala is effectively running Yoruba land. That is a fact of life. Yeah, I don't care what you say. That is a fact of life. That is why they're in the forest. They know that Mietiala is no match for IPOB. It's no match for ESN. So what they now cleverly did is they now brought whatever thing they have in there, the army they have clearly mapped out for the entire South. They now bring them to the East. Now, do you understand it? That is what they have done very cleverly. They think we are stupid. We don't have any brain. We cannot figure it out. That was why they insisted that Hope Uzodinma must be governor. Do you know why? Because they need their own man on the inside. And who took Hope Uzodinma to Janjaweed North? Is a George Obiozo. And who is George Obiozo? A very close confidant of Ibrahim Gambari. They are so-called whatever rubbish is called, chief of staff. The person actually now running things from behind the shadows since Buhari is dead. Do you understand? They divide you for a purpose. When you say, I'm a fig, I'm a Bibio, I don't want to Igbo, you are, they know, that is what they want you to say. That is why they have their camps in your villages. That is why they can destroy your crops, rape your mothers, kill you. You cannot say anything because they know that if all of us as Biafrans are together, they cannot come in. They can never come in. What do? They use some people. They use a few people and they use Yoruba media. That's what they do. A few people, they give them money and they use it to try to get you to begin to think individually. So they can pick you off one after the other. The same that is happening in Africa. One after the other. They gave you artificial boundaries and accepted it. Now they can pick you off. I hope I'm making some sense. Because sometimes most people do not reason very well. Go and tell me, if you can show me one governor from the North that ever invited the army, even at the height of terrorism and banditry in the North. None of them invited the army. The helicopters that you saw hovering over Olo never hovered around the bandits in the North. Instead, they sent Gumi, that very filthy, dirty-looking rag that claims an Islamic scholar. I don't know how a baboon from Africa can be an Islamic scholar. It defeats me. You have Arabs who can be scholars. You have people from Pakistan who can be scholars of Islam. A wretched buffoon who can't even speak Arabic. He's claiming he's an Islamic scholar. Let's allow them anyway. They can send Sheikh Gumi to go and see bandits. When Sheikh Gumi left the place as he did yesterday, he never told the army or the police where the bandits are. But you stupid idiots, some of you Igbo idiots, you cannot keep your mouth shut. I want you to learn, if at all some of you can learn, look at Sheikh Gumi negotiating and discussing with bandits who are murderers, rapists, and killers. Understand this very well. This time, Sheikh Gumi could not tell the army where the bandit, of course, they all know. Ask yourself, why is it that the army is bombing Oulu and they're not bombing terrorist bandits hideouts in the north? That tells you all you need to know. That is what is going to convince you that Hope Uzodinma is part and parcel of their plan. I know that some of you, maybe you will get your data from Hope Uzodinma. When he gets his security vote, he will share it, maybe 1,000 naira to some of you. And because you're black people, the need of the stomach will always supersede your need for freedom. That is why Africa is poor and very wretched, because we always put the need of the stomach. When somebody gives you 2,000 naira data, you start talking rubbish. When BBC comes to you and maybe gives you 20,000 naira, you start to talk rubbish. Do you understand it very clearly? You have people that claim, oh, we are intelligentsia, intellectuals, of course. They're in Abuja, in Lagos. And the same, I'm not asking them to support ESN or IPOB. What am I saying? Ask this simple question. Why is it that we have helicopters hovering in Oulu and not in Zamfara, not in Bauchi, not in Yobe, where you have bandits wreaking havoc every day? Simple question they cannot ask. In other words, all the leadership you have had after the war, they have all been compromised. Some of you should pray that IPOB can. Or should I say, pray that Chukwuka Abiyama determined that IPOB should come. If not, by now, you're all toast. If not for IPOB, believe you me, the entire South, including the Yoruba land world, have been firmly under Fulani control. We are the ones delaying them. If not for us, our people need a black person needs to be able to reason. Sit down and you will be able to reason to understand. If you see ESN at work, keep your mouth shut, Mechiano. Shut up your mouth and don't say anything. It is for a reason. Their own shape can go and see their bandits who are rapists and murderers, and they all keep quiet. All of you, some of you should just keep quiet. And no ill discipline will be tolerated within the ranks of ESN. No ill discipline. If you're asked to sit down somewhere, you sit and you wait. If you don't have onions is coming. You just wait. It's called supplies. You'll be resupplied. Not talking and making stupid deals. And I don't want anybody from the diaspora to send not one single dime, not one kobo to anybody anymore back home. If you do, we will regard that as subversion, that you are trying to destroy the work that God is doing in our lives. There are a lot of criminals, and we cannot condone such. People making videos claiming they are at the war front when they are not. Please stop it. I'm asking you to stop it. Why I invited soldiers to Oulu? I want all of you listening today to go and scour every newspaper publication since Buhari El-Rufai launched Boko Haram. It was Buhari that launched Boko Haram. Who doesn't know that? Unless you're a fool. The third Buhari, of course. The last one, not Aisha's boyfriend, having fun at Kempinski Hotel in Dubai. Understand what I'm saying very, very carefully. Show me where another... They have Boko Haram. They have Al-Qaeda in the Maghreb. They have ISIS in West Africa provinces. What? They have Fulani bandits. They have Fulani kidnappers. They have Ansari. They have all these things. I am asking you, please. That is where even the Western world is pumping in money to contain Boko Haram. Let me ask you. I want you to go and look for a publication where any of those northern governors from Sokoto to Borno ever invited or openly called on the army to come and attack their people. Only in Imo State. Are you following what I'm saying? Only in Imo State. And ask yourself, why is that the case? Why is that the case? That tells you all you need to know. The idiot even came out openly to boast why I invited the army to kill your own people. And these are the idiots that would tell me, oh, I saw the war, we are traumatized. The same army that traumatized you between 67 and 70 is in your town. You are inviting them to traumatize this very generation. When all we did was to try to drive away terrorists in our forests. That's the only thing that we did. He spoke through a judge He said, he spoke, please note this man's name down, and I want his picture everywhere. The state attorney general and commissioner for police in Imo State is gone, Kwa Obikon. Barrister Cyprian Akolisa. But I want his pictures everywhere. We need to find him. We must find him. I set an example with him. I'm saying it so that, as I said, we will keep doing what we're doing until I have told Hague, just write me, invite me. You have my email so I can come there. You don't need to spend money seeking to arrest me. I'll come to Hague myself. This idiot must be found. His name is Sip. As they have recruited Hope Uzodinma, he's now busy recruiting people for the caliphate. Recruiting people for the junkyard because they want to take our land. As somebody told me, they said if Ojo Zokal, if Fulani were to say to Ojo Zokal, we'll make you the president of Nigeria, but we need to kill 10 million Igbo people to do so. Ojo Zokal will say, why don't you make it 15 million? That's what somebody said to me yesterday. That is how evil these people are. They would do anything for money and power. Anything at all. These are people that sacrifice their grandmother. As long as one way go, they use their wives, they use their mothers to go and do money ritual. Oh, I don't believe in that rubbish anyway. They kill their mothers looking for money. Is it you they will not kill? That is why to appoint a criminal, people who have done Yahoo Yahoo or 419 like Opu Zodema into positions of power, you are only paving the way for your own destruction. And that's what they're doing. You know, no Fulani governor has ever called. Instead, they're asking you to go and negotiate with the bandits. These are murderers and killers. But in our land, people defending our land against bandits and terrorists, according to the directive of the Ministry of Defense, Hope Uzodinma is saying, go and kill them. And somebody will wake up in the morning and say, he's their leader. He's a governor. May Elohim have mercy on some of your useless lives. Very, very sad indeed. Ezekwesili have said something. I don't know. These are people that put Buhari in power, by the way. Did B-Bog bring back? You know, sometimes it's very fashionable. And some of our people we are doing when the young man emerged from Durban. You know, we Easterners, we love to eulogize outsiders. We love to be seen as being de-tribalized by working for outside interest against our own. That's what we do very well. I remember the obvious person running around antagonizing Jonathan. Of course, Jonathan's government was stupid anyway. Don't get me wrong. Very, very useless and corrupt. Useless and corrupt. Don't get me wrong. But everybody knows that Jonathan is a better option than Buhari. Everybody knows that. Or knew that then. OBS Equestria is now complaining. He condemned the abduction of 27 Kagara students from Niger State. Students were abducted in Niger State. Niger State has a governor. Did that governor invite the army and the police to be shooting at villagers? The answer is no. Only in Olu. Only in Olu. Because everybody, not everybody, most people, or should I say a very insignificant minority, are born to betray. Anything Janja would ask you to do, you would do. Instead of, of course, I do agree that the defeatist mentality some people developed after the war lingered on and lived with them, and they gave birth to children with that, a mentality of a defeated people. When you're faced with a grave danger like defeatism, you can stand up and fight or you can run. Most of them chose to run. OBS Equestria wanted to be seen as a Nigerian, a good Nigerian, supported Bring Back Our Girls, and Jonathan left office and they brought in a monster. Of course, the monster is long dead, but what the monster left behind is even worse. Buhari died and handed over power to Mietiala. That is why Garubashehu said, if I'm speaking, know that it is the president who is talking. So when Garubashehu said, Miet Yala is a legitimate part of the government, they are stakeholders in the government, that means it's the governing structure of Nigeria rests on what Miet Yala says or does. That's what it means. Miet Yala are the ones running you, and Miet Yala is the fourth largest terror group in the whole world. I want you to listen very carefully. I want you to understand what we are saying. I want your senses to begin to return back to you. I want people to listen to our broadcast. Just lie down in the night alone Leave your wife, your girlfriend, your boyfriend. Just listen. Sit down and listen to this broadcast at night without light. Turn everything off. Lie down. Use earpiece to listen to it. They said that Miyeti Yala, from the mouth, I'm not saying what people made up. Garba Shehu said, anything I say, or anything Femi Adesina says, consider it to be coming from the president. That's number one. And now the same person said that the fourth largest terror group in the world, Miyeti Yala, their nickname is Fulani Headsmen, the fourth largest terrorist group in the world is a legitimate stakeholder in the government of Nigeria. That was why they gave them 100 billion. That is why they are supporting them to have their terror bases in every forest and in every village across the South. Because Fulani plan is very simple. Britain came, was able to take our oil and gas from Biafra land and kill us in the process because people were too stupid to unite. Understand this very carefully. Now, Fulani, on the advice of the United Kingdom, is doing the same thing. The only reason why Fulani is doing what is because they believe that the Yoruba and Igbo can never come together. It's a very simple, clean game. And I try to pull out my head why my brothers and sisters in Yoruba land cannot see this. It is as clear as daylight. How did they hold Yoruba people to their position? In order to convince Yoruba to support them in their plan without Yoruba knowing it, they said to Yoruba, despite the presence of 7 or 6 seaports, only Lagos will be viable. We will give you Lagos. The only international airport that will be, they've closed Enugu down since, so Enugu is shut down, Enugu airport too. So-called international. The only airport that will work in the South is Lagos, whereas in the North, ordinarily Kebbi State has an international airport. Bruno, you can fly from there abroad. You can go to Morocco from there. You can go to Saudi Arabia from there. From Sokoto, the same thing. From Kano, the same thing. Everywhere in the North, they have up to 8 international airports in the North. Understand me very clearly, please. But in the South, you only have one. And those people from the South are saying they are part of one Nigeria. That is why I look at them as animals. I'm telling you the truth. Are you following me? Fulani came. I said to Yoruba, in order to show you that we are very serious, that Nigeria belongs to two of us, Yoruba didn't know that Fulani was about to swallow them. Fulani said, I will give you one seaport. I will close Calabar. I will close Zigwacha, Port Harcourt. I will close Warri. I will close Onan. Every seaport, only Lagos. They said, hey, yeah, you've arrived. We fought the war. We fought the war. We need to enjoy the spoils. I want you to listen to me very carefully. That was how they got the Yoruba, and today the Yoruba forests and farmlands. Then the next one, they said, oh, Yoruba, I tell you what, you are going to be the only viable airport. And to grow the economy of Lagos, most international flights into Nigeria will come in at night. Do you understand? Because when you land in Lagos at night, you have to sleep in a hotel, you have to spend some money. So you didn't know that before? Now I'm telling you, ask yourself, that is the reason why. Because I asked KLM in those days, why do you people always fly into Lagos at night? They said that's the slots they were given. It was only Virgin Atlantic that tried to break the mold. But even at that, Virgin will have to take off around 11 o'clock or close to midnight. So you must arrive in Lagos on time. You're not going to travel by road in the middle of the night. So you must arrive on time. And because most domestic flights are not reliable, you have to come to Lagos to sleep to be able to make your Virgin Atlantic flight in the night. Very clever, isn't it? I call it the economics of a very primitive people. And Yoruba accepted. Yoruba did not know it was a Greek gift. That was why they were trying to outline how close they are with the Yoruba people. That is why today they are in Yoruba land, they are in their forest trying to take them over, or if they have not taken them over already. Now, do you understand? That betrayal never pays. that if had some Yoruba people said, no, Iguacha, which is the core Port Harcourt, is viable seaport. Let's go there. Let us diversify the economy. They talk about diversification of the economy, and is there right before them? They cannot do anything about it. Let us open all the refineries. There is no need. Another Fulani man, Dangote. Dangote is the richest man in Africa, but Kano State has the highest concentration of poor people in the whole of Black Africa. Let's give Dangote the refinery. Rather than opening the one in Warren, the one in Iguacha, and you are in one Nigeria, and that you know all these facts, you still get up the next morning to say you are a Nigerian. God have mercy on your ignorance. Do you see how they divided the South and the East? So we in the East will be upset. Why should you only Lagos be the international airport? Why should only Lagos be the viable seaport? Some people from Yoruba will be responding, oh, leave it, we want it that way. Understand. Meanwhile, Fulani is sending their foot soldiers into our forests, both the East and the West. They have sent more to the West, so they are going to take the West with Fulani Janjaweed, and then they take the East with their army, and it's complete. And Britain will be enjoying, you know, Abuja, their high commissioner, because they are no longer in the EU. So British economy is suffering. They need our oil and gas for the next 8 years, uninterrupted. They need it. That was what they told Donald Trump. When Trump said to them, I'm getting a lot of disturbances about this Biafra issue. What do we do? Britain said to Trump, give us only 8 years. But unfortunately, Trump couldn't continue. That is, I'm telling you, confidential fact. Ask, they are listening to me right now. Ask any intelligence agency in the world, you know, they will give you these facts very clear and neat. That was why Trump never did anything. Trump was waiting for their 8 years to be complete. They need oil and gas for 8 years. Free. But now Trump is not there. Oh, dear me. We'll continue anyway, regardless. Of course, man cannot give us the Afrika. Only God in heaven that can. I want you to understand the game they're playing. I want you to understand how they divided the East and the West. Instead of us to fight a common enemy, we are busy bickering over ourselves. I bet they have an advantage. The Fulani has an advantage over the South. Because in Yoruba land, most of them are Muslims. And in this war, insofar as Nigeria is concerned, the supreme leader of all Muslims is just like having the Pope. The supreme leader of all Muslims in Nigeria is a Fulani man, is a Sultan of Sokoto, and can never be a Yoruba man. The only way that Yoruba Muslims can feel that they have arrived on their own is only if there is an Oduduwa state, if Oduduwa nation were to stand. Because as long as I want Yoruba people, Yoruba Muslims to understand, as long as Nigeria continues to exist, your supreme leader is the Sultan of Sokoto. In other words, anything Sultan of Sokoto goes in Yoruba land without people knowing it. That is why they groomed Tinubu now. He's a Muslim, Yoruba Muslim. That was why they managed to groom. Their divide and rule didn't start today. I want Yoruba to understand this. The divide and rule you have in Nigeria started. That was why they also groomed Samuel L. Akintola to fight Awolowo. And do you understand me now? I said Akintola. Their grooming did not start today. That was why they allowed Go On to be there as a Christian for 11 years. And after that, now when Danjuma speaks, they said to Danjuma, you are today because of us. Ask yourself this question: where else on this planet, even in Congo or in Rwanda or elsewhere in Africa, will you have the army hovering and firing from an aircraft instead of the BBC to come out to say the army is even carrying out an operation in Oro? BBC came out to try to sell the narrative that nothing is happening. BBC. I want people to understand the depth of the subterfuge going on, the deception going on. If you cannot see, I'm not even saying it's conspiratorial, so you can't see it. This is very clear, it's very open. Ask yourself why the seaports are not working in the East. Why? In the same Atlantic Ocean, with the same seaport built many years ago, why is it not working? Because Fulani convinced Yoruba, don't worry, let's share Nigeria together. You get all the economy and we take the power. Yes. And people are saying that they hold economic power because they don't have any brain. And after that, tell me why they will stop us from eating stockfish. What did we do to them? But because stockfish contributes to the growth of the economy of the East. Why would they stop secondhand clothing from coming into Aba? Because they know it will contribute to the economic growth. It was done by Obasanjo. Obasanjo did it. These are evil men, evil men. You don't know that before. And after doing all these things to the children of God, you want to enjoy life in Nigeria? It's not possible. We are the chosen race. God loves Biafran people. There is nothing you can do about it. You can do your envy from now to the kingdom come. It can never save you. The same with Israel. No, you can be as envious as you like. As so Obasanjo was busy strangling the economy of the East, so too was God also busy strangling the economy of Nigeria. And they know it. They understand it very well. And that is why we are going to prevail. This is a live presentation. We are live and direct. The time now is 7 minutes. I believe it is past 8 p.m. in the land of Biafra. I am in Houston, Texas, preaching to you the gospel of redemption of the kingdom of heaven upon the face of this earth. Biafra. We call it Republic of Biafra. But I have said it before, we are not going to have a republic when you have crowned heads like monarchs. It doesn't make any sense to anybody. A republic means a land run by the people, not a monarch. So our people will need to go into that debate and decide, do you want a republic or do you want a quasi-monarchical regime where you have the do you want, is that what you want? So you must make up your mind. You're not going to have both. In America, that is, I'm here in a republic. There is no king. There is no royal majesty. There is no royal highness here. In every republic around the world, there is no royal majesty. In places like Netherlands or Sweden, they do not call themselves a republic because they have crowned heads. They have the crown to look up to. It's simple common sense. Some of you have political science departments, but you learn nothing. Every blessed year you come out, you just say, your brains are empty. So Biafrans, decide, what do you want? A republic or not? A republic, you don't have any king. No Igwe, no Eze. Chibwe, the God Almighty in heaven, is the king. And that is the type of Biafra that I want. But I'm letting everybody to understand we must all protect ESN. Mind what we write, what we say, who we gossip to. Keep your mouth shut. And I am making it very clear, I have not mandated anybody to solicit for funds for ESN. Anybody coming to you asking for funds to support ESN, that person is a rogue, is a thief. If you support them, you are enabling the cause of the Janjaweed to take over our land, because what you're doing will bring curse upon us. You are in ESN, you must stay there. If you're out, then you're out. Don't let anybody outside know you are part and parcel of ESN. It is very, very important. And our enemies are going to die. That I assure you. That I assure you. And they, of course, they know it. They know how stubborn we are. Do you think they will go free? Even for flying with a helicopter, you think we can allow them to go free? You've got to be joking. You must be joking. So anything that happens in Imo State, you know who to hold responsible for it. Now they're killing us and shooting from the top as the cowards they are. Oh, none of you can see it. All of you have gone deaf and dumb. The executives of everyone is dumb. All those idiots, all those intellectuals in Abuja, you have all gone deaf and dumb. You cannot see what's happening in Olo. You cannot see what Hussein Adema is doing in Olo. All of you are blind. You can't see it. And I'm also letting Yoruba media to know, the more you keep quiet, the more what is happening in the East will also happen in the West. You have seaport. Are you using it? Is it not congested? Are you using it? Are people having fun? Using only one seaport in a country of supposed 200 million people? Common sense must prevail. Why I ordered the soldiers into all? Hey! When it starts happening, when that rain starts to fall in Imo State, don't say I did not warn you. Don't say I did not warn all of you. Oh, you are trying to throw our land into a theater of war. Now they brought war to our land. You cannot see it. You are blind. You are foolish. You can't see it. But of course, we are coming. And the Fulani herdsmen do not need permission to occupy our forests. Being a former colony, not a former, being a colony of Britain, that Nigeria, after all, it was UK that created Nigeria. Some people don't know where they got the name United Kingdom from. Scotland voted to join England to form a union over 350 years ago. It was called the Act of the Union, the Union Act. That was where they decided to answer United Kingdom. Are you following me? But in our land, Britain decides who should live or who should die. Isn't it very funny? Who are you, IPOB, to destroy what a white man created? You are black, you're niggers. Who are you to destroy? Do you know we are England? We are Britain. We created you. And to do that very job perfectly for them, they brought the Fulani. The same thing they're doing with Hopus or them. Every oppressor will always have an inside agent working for them. They are called saboteurs. They are called traitors. And as long as they live, you can never be free. Go ahead and read your history now. As long as traitors are alive, they are more dangerous than the enemy. Hopus Odemma brought army to kill his own people in Olo, whereas his counterpart in Bauchi went to Niger Republic to bring Fulani to come and occupy our land. Lord have mercy. And they don't need this. Do you know why I said that Nigerians are mad people? Do you know why I said that anybody calling him or herself a Nigerian is an animal? Do you know why I said that? In the news today, this same Bauchi state governor that is the flag bearer of Fulani hegemony in the zoo called Nigeria, they are the ones that told us, listen, they are the ones that told us before that all these herdsmen killing, they are from Fulani from the north. Sorry, from outside Nigeria. Are you listening to me? They are Fulani from outside Nigeria, not inside Fulani. Now they are telling us that those Fulani, they call them terrorists from outside Nigeria. They are now in our forest and nobody can remove them. I want you to put it into context with what Hopus Odemma is doing in the state. They are criminals from outside, Fulani criminals, bandits, rapists, murderers from outside. That was what they told us. They said these are foreign bandits from Mali. That was what Fulani governor said. And that's a rock. And the spokespeople for the late Buhari. Today, the same murderers, the same rapists, the same land-grabbing demons, the same terrorists, the same bandits, we are being told that nobody can remove them from our forest. And you say you're a Nigerian, make up our work there. You people are mad, insane human beings, people are fools. You know, I would have thought maybe that black people are sensible. You see, when I look at Nigeria, believe you me, I know that black people are useless. They are the most useless thing to ever grace creation. I'm telling you the truth. Somebody said, an armed robber came to my house and I asked you, why are you raping me? Why are you killing me? Why are you? You said, no, they are from outside town. And then you come back to tell me that same person raping and killing me, I should give me a room in my house. And I don't even have the right to remove him. A rapist, a murderer, I don't have the. Oh, she making that here. Oh, God. That's why I said that Biafra is the last miracle. If given the stupidity of black people, the overwhelming force fighting against us, Biafra comes, it will be the greatest miracle in the history of mankind. But of course it's coming. Nobody's going to stop it. Somebody came to my house, killed me, raped my mother, went to Ozowani, massacred us. Who killed us at Ozowani? They said it's a Fulani from Mali, from Niger, from Cameroon. They went to Ebonyi. They said, who killed us? Oh, don't worry, no. It's not from in Nigeria. It's from outside. It's outside. Who allowed them to cross the border? No one can tell us. Okay, who gave them the guns? No one. So are you saying, did they cross the border with the guns? Don't we have people at the border checking who comes in and who leaves? That is enough to tell Yoruba people, to tell Igbo people, to tell Oduduwa, to tell Biafra, that you people must be come together. You must, the only border you have, Sammy, they close it down. And you're telling me you're a Nigerian. And they're playing with your senses and playing with your brain. Even the zoo, they want to start, they want to formalize. They want to make, to give Sheikh Gumi his own share of the money. They want to set up what they call bandits commission to pay rapists. They want to compare them to the noble Niger Delta militants that fought for freedom. Did Niger Delta militants kidnap schoolgirls? Did they rape anybody? Did they take over anybody's farm? The answer is no. But you have, this is full and ginger with reasoning. Today, they are telling you that they have to negotiate with the government. Someone has to lead it. And since Sheikh Gumi is doing a good job, how much do you need? He will say 4.4 trillion. They will give him. They will go and borrow money from South Korea and give him. But in your own land, in Imo State, the governor is asking the army that should be fighting bandits in the north to come and kill villagers. And you're telling me that such a person deserves to live? I don't know if I'm going to take any calls at all this very day. I have no idea if I'm going to take any calls, but I will go on to preach that a lot of criminals are claiming that they have the right channel to deliver aid and help and support to ESN. I am warning everybody in the diaspora and even back home. There is only one channel through which support and fundraising is done. Do not give money to anybody. You people are the ones encouraging them to be doing all these videos. And in the process of doing all these videos, our location, ESN location, is being given out inadvertently. People are complaining we have no salt, we have no soap, we have no detergent. You people are putting the lives of people in danger. And that nonsense has first stopped from yesterday. I am making it very, very clear that we have one account here in the United States of America. Very clear. If you call the necessary people, if the money is returned back to you, then you call our finance teams that will tell you where to put the money. Very, very important, please. Let nobody come to you to deceive you. Let nobody be parading him or herself saying they're collecting money for ESN. It is not done. That is not how we do things. That person is a thief, is a criminal, and please do not pay them any attention. And with that, we have come to the end of our very brief, I've been here for nearly 1.5 hours, I believe, of our program this way. I don't know if we are in a position. Do we have our lines to be able to take some calls? I don't know. Do we have our lines to maybe take one or two calls from the USA, if possible? Do we have it?
Yes, we do.
Yes, we do. I will see if any of the lines, I don't want any calls from back home, please. We know what is happening in Oulu, and we are responding accordingly. It's not everything that we do that we are going to tell you about, please. The calls I want are those from the United States of America, because they are the ones, to an extent, that holds the key to what we are doing. They are the ones that hold the key to what we are doing. Somebody says they want to make, his name is Remigius. I want to say your first name. He said I need to reach him because he has a very important contribution to make. I hope that that contribution is also financial, because no bullet that leaves a gun comes back again as a new one. You have to buy a new bullet in order to continue to do your very marvelous work, I believe, that the ESN is doing at the moment. I don't know what is happening. I'm going to have to call some people back, because it's just the calls are too much, and it is not getting through. But I want to be able to call. Yeah, I may be able to call some people back, please. I may be able to call some people back. If I call you back, please try and take your call. The caller on the line, can you hear me? This is Radio Biafra. We are live and direct. Your name and where you are speaking from.
Yes, Mazi. Good afternoon from here. My name is Judo Kafo. Judo Kafo is from Agbo. Agbo is Anioma. Anioma is Biafra.
Is Anioma Biafra?
Yes, Anioma is Biafra and Anioma is Igbo.
Thank you very much. Please go.
Because there is no Fulani, there is no Yoruba, there is no Benin that is answering to Kafo. is not an Igbo man that answer Okafor.
You are blessed.
Thank you, Mazi. It's a privilege and honor. In fact, today is the best day of my life to speak to you. I am so humble. I am so grateful to Chukwu Abiyama to allow you to pick my phone today. Mazi, the Chukwu Abiyama, the God of my ancestors, continue to protect and guide you. Yes, for the wonderful work you are doing to liberate us, Biafra, not minding your position, not minding who you are, but you protect yourself to make sure that we, the children of the land of the rising sun, are saved, are out of that zoological republic of Nigeria to a promised land that Chukwu Abiyama have promised us. May Chukwu Abiyama continue to bless you. I just want to appreciate you. And like you said, we are listening to you. Anioma is Biafra and Anioma is Igbo. Mazi, we will follow you. We will do whatever you want. And we will stand by you 101%. There is no going back until Biafra comes. May Chukwu Abiyama bless you.
Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from New York.
You are in New York. Okay.
Yes.
Hopefully, I'll be in New York during the summer. Thank you very much.
That would be nice, Maz. We'll be hoping to see you there.
Thank you very, very much. I remember. Thank you very, very much. These are people that know where they come from. They know where they come from and they know where they're going. Not to you. So we are Anioma. We are Delta Igbo Anioma. Useless fools. The caller on the line, can you hear me? Your name and where you are. We are live and direct, and the entirety of humanity is listening.
Thank you, sir. Maz, good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon to you.
My name is Ohagbeni Chukwumobia, formerly known as Imam Agada. I'm calling you from America.
Where in America are you in?
From New York, Bronx.
Bronx in New York. Thank you very much. Please go ahead.
My leader, I want to thank you and appreciate you for all the good jobs you are doing. Now, there is one suggestion I want to make about the way to raise money to support this our noble men in the forest. You know, I come from Enugu State. In my own community, and people spend millions and millions every year sponsoring and equipping a neighborhood watch. And these people always kill our people. Now, most of them will sponsor a neighborhood watch, go back to Nigeria police to take somebody to follow them with gun. So I want to ask, is it not possible for us to organize in a way to make these people support ESL from every local government and every community in Biafra land? Why I'm saying this is because ESL is not a question of Biafra, succession or not succession. It has to do with our survival. Now, if that ESL will be swallowed, even those people, and if the terrorists have to come to our community, they are the ones that are the prime target. Nobody will kidnap all these poor people. So I want to ask if it is possible for IPOB leadership to map out plan so that people from different communities, we have every community all over, we have another community, other community everywhere, so that they will be supporting what we are doing. At least ESM is giving us protection and even giving job to our civil unemployment, unemployed youth in our land. This is what I want to ask. Thank you, my leader.
Thank you very much. And your question is in order. And we are doing that. We are putting that in place. Every association, every group will receive a list of all our land, bushes and forests under occupation by the Janjaweed. If they want that occupation to continue, that's entirely up to them. You know, sometimes it can be a bit difficult. You know, we are a bunch of funny people, but this time around, we are going to do exactly what you suggested. And thank you very much. And make sure you are part and parcel of IPAB family where you are.
Wonderful.
That is very good. I am grateful. Very grateful for your call and your advice and your suggestion, which has been taken on board and will be acted upon. Thank you very, very much for that. We have another caller on the line. This caller, I can see that you are not calling us from the United States.
My name is I'm calling from Valencia City of Spain. Hey, my leader, I thank you. I thank God for you. God will continue to protect you. For you to bring out yourself out to liberate your people. Chukwukadebam continue to bless you. Majin Nange Kanu. Today is my first time of getting you online since so many years. More than 5 years I've been trying to get you. I keep trying now that I got you on phone. Today I will sleep very well. Chukwukadebam continue to bless you. Anybody looking for your dancer will just use land to cover, the water will cover him. Lord will continue to bless you, my leader Nande Kanu. Please keep doing what you are doing. And all those people criticizing you, all those are our enemy, they will not see good thing in their life. Continue to do your this, God will continue to bless you. Through Christ our Lord.
Thank you very much, Madam. I don't care who criticizes or doesn't criticize, it's irrelevant. If you don't criticize me, that means I'm not doing anything. Are you going to criticize somebody who's not doing anything? I love it. Without criticism, I'm not even happy. I love it. Gossipers must gossip. Those of us working must work. The caller on the line, can you hear me? The world is listening. Your name and where you are.
Yes, my name is Ebo Akalonu. I live in Dallas, Texas. I'm a member of the IPOB.
Wonderful. Go ahead. Akalonu, go ahead, please.
I'm in Biafra.
Go ahead.
Mazi, please, I need an appointment with you. I've spoken with Mr. Alozie. I'm just trying to get an appointment with you. I need to talk to you physically. Very important. Dr. Tina is involved. All of them are trying to let me meet with you. Please give me an appointment. It's very important.
Okay. If you have Dr. Tina's details, go through her and speak to my secretary, and time will be scheduled. You know, I have a very hectic diary. And time will be made out for us to see. So speak to my secretary, please, so we can take it on from there.
I don't know her number. Or if she can I speak with her right now?
You have Tina. Is that you have Dr. Tina's details? Is that correct?
Yes, Tina and Alozie.
Yeah, Dr. Tina will give you the details. Very, very important. She will give it to you.
Okay. Please. Thank you, man. I'm happy to speak with you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I remember blessed. Thank you very, very much. Somebody who wants to speak to us. You know that because of this whole the cold weather here, and also the presence, the ever threatening presence of COVID, we are not able to travel as widely as we had intended. So what I need to do is to return to Europe and then, or to Israel as the case may be, and then come back here in the summer. That's what I'm going to do. The caller on the line, can you hear me? Your name and where you are, please.
Hello, Director. Let me say good morning from here. This is Osita Wezok. I'm calling from Canada.
From Canada, thank you very much. Wezok, thank you.
Yes, brother, we acknowledge your good work, and to say we are not here not to praise you, because we can't praise you. Then we'll only say keep on the good work. Yeah, I have some things to contribute here. Number one is, please, we trust you. We know you see things before they happen. But I want to stress that in this one, I might add more small ego. Because here in Andozone, I now quite don't have, especially in the Ndumba, Ndunokataranya, I now quite don't have manapiko. History will always beat itself. Having said that, I want to also reiterate that, you see, with IPOB in general should not be carried away with what is going on now, because a lot of people you see waking up today, either communities or ethnicities waking up today, many of them, even some people shouting Biafra today is because what they are seeing in Nigeria today, because the dead Buhari took over. As soon as somebody who they think they have some little sense takes over Nigeria leadership, you see them falling the other part. Only few of us who only want our identity is restored, not minding whether Nigeria is London, will remain. So IPOB should have that in mind and continue in the right path till Biafra is restored. And again, is
My leader, I have a lot of things to share, but maybe I will have to stop here for now. You know, this call, sometimes you call, you're not answered. Before you get answered, sometimes you forget some of things you want to say. But all I'll say is keep on your good work, Director. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, my dear brother. Thank you very, very much for that. I have another caller on the line. This caller, can you hear me? Your name and where you are, and turn your system down, please. Can you turn it down? Can you turn it down? I picked up the call, but they were not able to understand. I think somebody's calling from home. Let's see. The caller on the line, can you hear me?
Hello?
You are not ready. When you're calling us, you have to be ready with what you have to say. Very, very important, please. When you are calling us, please be ready. Not when you're not ready, you'll be calling us. It doesn't make any sense to me. When you're calling us, please be ready. Be ready for what you have to say. Please be ready. I have multiple calls. The caller on the line, can you hear me, please?
Yeah, I hear you clear. My name is Okechukwu Okafo from Omonya, Oyi local government area of Anambra State, Biafra land.
You are Okafo from Omonya. We have another Okafo from Anioma, and yet they say Anioma is not Igbo. Some people are very, very foolish. Please go ahead, my dear brother. Go ahead.
Maze, may God continue to bless you always.
You say?
We always pray to God. Any evil, anywhere they came from, they will fall.
You say?
Keep doing the good work. All the whole world are with us. No matter what enemy do, they can never succeed. They can never near us because we are ahead of them.
You say?
May God continue to bless you in anything you are doing. I'm calling from New York City, and we hope we see you in New York very soon.
May God
continue to bless you in the mighty name of Jesus.
He say, Nam Gozieri, Wachineke. I have a caller on the line. This caller, can you hear me? You are calling from home. I can see that. Please go ahead. Your name and where you are.
Sir.
Good evening to you.
Thank you very much. My name is Pastor Jack. I'm calling from Lagos, to be precise. Leader, I want to sincerely appreciate you and your good work. We have to trust and believe in you that God will use you to restore Biafra in our own time. All I want our people to do is to kill behind our leader and support, give ESN the maximum support, just like he said. Many of the people who publish on social media, they don't even know what we're doing. They will just be writing. So our people should be mindful of the things they write. Any department that does not concern you, don't interfere. Just relax. Allow those who are in charge of a particular project or something to do that particular thing. And I know God on our side and in his infinite mercy, we shall restore Biafra because our minds are made up. It's either we restore Biafra or all of us just go into oblivion. Thank you, and may Chukwu Okereba continue to bless our leader. In Chukwu Okereba's name, I pray, sir.
He said, thank you for that. Thank you very much. I have another caller on the line. This caller, can you hear me? Can you hear me? No, they cannot hear me. I have another caller. The caller on the line, can you hear me?
Yes. I can hear you.
Thank you very much. Please, your name and where you're calling us from, if you may.
My name is Eobuchenna Ibe. I'm calling from Texas, Houston here.
From Houston, Texas, very close to me, I believe. This is very, very big. Magadi Amama. Please go ahead.
Welcome, and thank you so much for your wonderful work.
Thank you.
I actually want to make a suggestion with regard to what's going on at Olo. You know, Israel has a policy that no war should ever be fought on their soil. Yes. I'm thinking in the line of taking, you know, this battle to the enemy, instead of them coming to our land, you know, to mess up the way they're doing. We can try to take the battle to them and strike them at places they least expected, you know.
It's a good idea. But also mind that Israel right now is a sovereign state and we are not. And before Israel managed to establish their sovereignty, they had to actually fight from within to outside. That's how it's done. once we become a sovereign state, I don't think any country will be foolish to try to invade Biafra land. So we know what we are doing. The rest assured that we know. In terms of the strategies we are deploying to defend our land, we know what we are doing.
Okay, I appreciate it. Thank you for the good job you are doing. Thank you and God bless you.
And you too. Thank you very much. I did actually ask him if he's part and parcel of this family. I have another caller on the line. This caller, can you hear me? The caller on the line, can you hear me? No, they cannot hear me. I have a caller on the line. This caller, give us your name and where you are, please.
I'm Oyendo. That's the son from here. My name is Nnamdi Nwankwo. I'm calling from the other place, USA. I'm from Ogo, in Enugu, Neverland.
Ogo, Fulani people are there. Do you know that?
Yeah, I know.
So what is Uncle Commit in USA doing? What is the Enugu meeting in USA doing to combat what Fulani people are doing there?
I'm actually not their member. I'm only principal assistant, deputy assistant coordinator. Yeah.
Okay.
What I want to contribute is 1967 to 1974. You have lectured me everything about what happened. My own sacrifice there for Biafra. We are in diaspora, and we are here for our people back home. Our people back home, they are there for us. All these politicians are able land anywhere. This fire they are burning. This fire they want to mitigate. Mazi, count me as one of the frontier. Whenever they travel to abroad, anywhere, any country, Mazi, I will do something to protect our people back home. Because look at the way, I never said any country in the world, where a visiting governor of the land in Chicago here. Because CNN is not carrying the news. In Chicago here, I don't shoot here. Since I come to America, I don't shoot because of Chicago. But I never see no governor. I've never bring the military with gun here. They're going to be bombing their land. Come to governors. Then they come abroad, come and enjoy their life. When this fire, they are instigating start to burn. Thank you, Mazi.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And you have spoken very well. You have spoken very, very well. You have spoken very well. And I support you entirely. I support you in what you are saying. Those people are evil, though. Evil men. I want people to please try to call us on the direct line. Don't call on WhatsApp or Signal. There are WhatsApp and Signal functionality, but please do not call us on it. I have somebody else on the line. Don't call us on Signal, please, or WhatsApp. Do not do that. Call us direct. Call us direct on the line, please. It makes our life a lot more easier. Please. And I want to hear from those of them in the United States of America. I am in the U.S. And I would like to, people are calling us from Austria, from everywhere they're calling us from, right across the face of this very planet Earth. They are calling us. We must take this call. The caller on the line, can you hear me, please? Your name and where you are.
Hello.
Yes, please.
Yeah, I'm calling from Vienna, Austria, Mazen Nandekano.
Thank you. Please give us your name.
Yeah, I'm Alphonsus Dewe. I'm from Ubuntu Kingdom. In Delta State.
I don't know. Are you Delta or you are Igbo? I don't know how to put it anymore.
No,
I've lost count.
I'm from Biafra land.
Thank you very much.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes. I want to thank you for everything you have been doing, and I must use this time to say I'm very sorry for not accepting the truth from the very first time you started. Well, I may say that I'm among these people that said that it's too insultive, but the truth remains the truth. I must appreciate and I must tell you that everything you have been doing, Chukwu Ike Abiema, is by you.
Yes, sir.
It's in your front to protect you. It's in your back to go after you. Is in your right, is in your left. It's in your up, is in your down to lift you up. And whomsoever that fight against these positive moves must go down. So I want to contribute something. Like, these people that are bringing Nigerian military to our territory, I think that before that we proceed, it's time to bring them down too, like this, our wicked governors that are working for these Fulanis. Yes. So I just say, let me contribute and for us to put it in mind, because it will not continue like this, because people are dying. And again, the, what they call it, BBC Igbo, or what they call it, that BBC, I don't know what they are doing. Who is operating it?
It's Britain now, United Kingdom. That it was they got some idiots with Igbo names to be there, trotting out their line and supporting the Fulani invasion of our land. BBC is in full support of the Fulanization agenda of the Janjaweed. And it doesn't matter what their name is. Even those working for BBC, but they're even worse than those working for BBC Pidgin and BBC Hausa. They are worse.
Yeah.
They are being controlled from Britain.
May your days be long. And whatsoever that will happen to you or the ESN, may it happen to the millions of Fulani Janjaweed.
You see?
Protect you always.
And you
thank
too.
You for your good work.
Thank you very much. Thank you very, very much, my dear brother. Thank you very much for that. We are live and we are direct and the whole world is listening, of course, and we expect them to. Everywhere you go, right across the face of this very planet Earth, people are listening to us as they should. As they should, people are listening to us. Sometimes the calls are so many that I have to try and call back. That I have to try and call back anybody who is from Anioma, and you say you're not Igbo. May Fulani Janjaweed locate you. May they ravage you. May they take your land from you. That is what I have. Well, that is what I have to say. I have a caller on the line.
May the Lord continue to bless you.
He said,
"Sir, I'm so annoyed with what all this useless governors we have in our land are doing. And sir, see, Mika has gone his own, and he I'm saying it that it's because of nothing has happened. That is why Corporate of Ima has the temerity to invite military. And not wicked deed. Today, our people are still in the north, suffering. Those are not wicked deed. Our people are just, like, our women are there, being excluded again, being there to be assault and harm because of the recent of our governors. And now, this is so good that they are doing his own again. And if we keep allowing these people, sir, another person, we don't know what other people may do tomorrow. It's because of what they do, if they're still alive. All these useless, because of they allow these people to be alive. Because of they are working freely, because we know this, we know their home. We know where they live. None of them that their house has been bombed. None of them that anything that concerns them has been destroyed. We show these people how that in a lot of times they don't know that no matter how hungry are goods, grazing in the middle of the forest are never the best because they are wild animals. It's because of the, we never told these people that mind of wild animals we are, that mind we have to respect the emperor, that is leading the have to be doing this and be taking out we have that are untouchable. These people are not untouchable, sir. They are never untouchable. They are not human beings. If you go and don't penetrate them, life penetrate them. If God don't penetrate them, the other things are penetrating them. And that is enough for all these things. We can't keep on like this, sir. We can't just keep on like this. I want these people. The more they are with us, the more we allow these people to be with us, the more this struggle is being hard for us. These people need to be taken care of. Once and for all.
Thank you, my brother. You have spoken very well. You have spoken, and I believe that most people will say that this is amongst the very sensible contribution we've had today in this very program. I thank you very much for your call, and they cannot go free. And the reason why we do what we do is because so those that may seek to support them when the time comes understand what their crimes are. I thank you all for your calls, those who have listened. I know it wasn't imagined. It wasn't even advertised, but I said I'll broadcast every 2 days. That was what I said. I thank you all for listening. Regardless of where you are, regardless of what you've had to say, that we do appreciate it. And as always, and without any hesitation, we proclaim very clearly and unequivocally down to here. People may say their religion to be maybe A or B or C. As for us, the diehard and the hardcore, Biafra is our religion. Here on Radio Biafra is where we worship, because Elohim is our God. From me, from here, this sunny but cold afternoon in Houston, Texas, it is good afternoon.
Our lives in pain and misery. never gonna trade our freedom with any mystery. It's affecting our soul and it's killing us so slow. With what we've been through, we are far from being good. But we are blessed by Chukwudika Bioma. So we're never gonna give up,
we're never gonna give up.
There'll be light in the wind of a tunnel.
It will shine so bright all time.
The whole world will embrace the nobody can stop us, nobody can cage us, nobody can stand us, yeah. They will know, they will know.
The sun is rising.
From east to west, from north to south.
Can't you see the sun is rising?
All your way you fly, and be proud of who you are.
Because the sun is rising.
We're shining so bright, all over the world. Revealing. When I think about how blessed we are, goosebumps all over my body. Sunrise to the black stripes. Black strands crossing gray stripes. Clashes upon clashes. Many lives turn to ashes. When I ponder and reminisce, the actions I see malice. Blood on the ground, this is how we fly. Our beautiful flag all around the world.
Blood on the ground, this is how we fly. Our beautiful flag all around the world.
We go carry the cross together. We walk through to Zion. We stumble, we rise.
Out of victory we'll shine.